20 teammates to attempt 20 field goals each per game. Jalen thinks he's got this right. I've got it written down where he thinks he's got it right.
So since you put 35 seasons, I wanted to use all of that time. So that goes back to what, like mid, late 80s?
Yeah.
You know what? My first guess was actually going to be Paul Pierce and Antoine Walker. But my actual answer is going to be Russell Westbrook and Kevin Durant.
Man, okay. That was actually wrong, but you were half right. I have proof that he was half right on his paper. No one can read that, so it doesn't matter.
Gotcha.
Good job, Sneaky Gordo. That was great. So let's
nice
get
one,
back
Gordo. You got
to
it.
James Harden and Russell Westbrook teaming up, and they both hit that mark last season. Wow. They love to have the ball. Harden's usage rate last season was second highest in the last 30 years. The only player ahead of him was Russell Westbrook in 2017. Now, both do a ton of their damage, specifically in isolation. According to Second Spectrum, Harden executed over 20 isolations per game last season, by far the most in the NBA. Westbrook ranked fourth with 9.9. So can Westbrook play off the ball alongside Harden? Last season, Russ had the third lowest effective field goal percentage on catch and shoot by any player with at least 300 attempts. So we got our own coach here in Seth Greenberg, and we thought we'd get into this a little bit. How do you, as a coach, manage having both of these guys, the advantages that Mike D'Antoni will have on having Westbrook in this offense from your standpoint?
I think Russell Westbrook fits perfectly in Mike D'Antoni's offense, because what is Mike D'Antoni's offense? Mike D'Antoni's offense is what? Threes, layups, and what? Dunks and free throws. Watch right here. Russell Westbrook, he's going to catch the ball in a closeout. What can he do? He can get in the lane. He can get paint touches. And when you get paint touches, what does the defense do? The defense has to react. He's got eight eyes on him right now. When those eight eyes are on him, what happens? All of a sudden, people are open. So now all of a sudden, whether it's Gordon, whether it's Tucker. Oh, by the way, what about the guy up in the right? The beard. All right. All of a sudden, dribble penetration, kick out, three. Oh, by the way, dunker spot. That's kind of a new phrase in basketball right now. You get to the rim, you got the dunker spot. Oh, and by the way, also, he can still be Russell Westbrook. He can get to the rim and punish people. I think in that system, his ability to get paint touches, get penetration, the ability for Houston to shoot the three, get to the free throw line, they're going to have the first and second players in the NBA on free throws attempted, free throws made, also the first two guys in assists. So I think that Russell Westbrook fits perfectly, perfectly in Mike D'Antoni's system.
Okay, so there you have it. Some people question this marriage. You think it works out lovely.
Lovely.
Good stuff. SportsCenter, 6 p.m. after PTI with L. Duncan and Matt Berry. They'll look at why James Harden is better off with Russell Westbrook than Chris Paul. Plus, what's next in OKC and the difference between Roger Federer and Rafael Nadal today. SportsCenter after PTI on ESPN and the ESPN app. All right, our next guest is someone who does it all. You've seen him on 21 and 22 Jump Street, Straight Outta Compton, Are We There Yet, and so many other great films. Ice Cube produces, raps, acts, directs, writes, and is also the founder of the Big Three
Friday,
basketball
the hood,
tournament.
Barbershop.
I mean, we're in the presence of greatness,
yes,
Jalen. I
just mobile. Don't.
Exactly. I'm not sure if there's anything that you don't do, but you're also a basketball fan, of course, and we
yes.
talked about the Big Three. I like the swag you've got going on here. Mm-hmm. What's your reaction just as a basketball fan to the craziness of this free agency that's happened this season?
I love it. You know, to me, that's what it's all about. You know, shaking it up a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, the Warriors have been so dominant. You know, for the last 5 years, it seemed like everybody at the start of the season is hollering Warriors, Warriors, Warriors. Not this year. You know, everybody's it's up in the air, and it's going to be great for fans to sit back and check out good basketball.
Ice Cube is the Don Mega, and I have to tell you, your Lakers have not made the playoffs, as you know, in the last 6 years. However,
to him.
You got LeBron James and Anthony Davis now.
Yeah.
What are your expectations?
Definitely making the playoffs for sure.
Let's start there.
They better. But, you know, going deep, we got a new team, new coach, new players. You know, you got to give them time to gel. You know, you can't expect them to win the championship this year, but you got to expect them to go deep. And they're gonna be all right. I ain't worried too much about the Lakers.
Okay, so what do you have to say to some of these people that are like, oh, the Clippers are taking over Los Angeles?
In what universe?
I try to tell people, I lived
That's
in L.A. for 25
happen.
Years. That's never going to happen.
It's never going to happen. You know, the Clippers haven't won in their franchise history. So until they do it.
Tell Marcellus that again.
Man, come on, Marcellus. Stop it. You know, but, you know, I see why they're happy.
Yeah.
But I've seen this movie before, and it's the same ending.
It's the same ending.
Yes.
But they did add Kawhi.
Yes.
They did add Paul George.
Yep, great players.
Who do you feel like could go further this year between those two teams, Lakers and the Clippers?
I'm going to say the Lakers. I'm going to say the Lakers for sure. Just because they've done it before as an organization.
Mm-hmm.
Clippers never done it. So until they do it, why should I be a believer? Why should I stick my neck out?
So you do have a relationship with Magic Johnson, good friend of yours.
Yes.
What would you say about just the way that all of that unfolded with what the Lakers ended up getting and how all of it played out?
Well, I guess it happened the way, you know, when they first got together, Rob and Magic, I was like, how is this going to work? So it kind of happened how I expected it to happen, that it wasn't going to work. You know, if Magic does something good, he has to share the success. And if he does something bad, it's all on Magic. So I didn't like that for him. And, you know, I want Magic to be Magic. When Magic can't be Magic, he's in the wrong spot. So, and that's even as the, you know, head of the Lakers or the head of player operations or whatever you want to call it. So, you know, I think it's the right move for both parties.
For those that don't know, give them a heads up about what's happening with the Big Three.
Oh,
I'm trying to make sure I'm at the game this Sunday to come represent.
Yeah.
I saw Joe Johnson trending the other day because he was balling.
He's a problem. The Big Three, you know, week four, when Providence, Rhode Island at noon tomorrow, Brooklyn on Sunday, you know, great matchups. You know, guys going for it. You know, they starting to see, you know, you're going to be out of the playoffs if you don't turn it around, or, you know, you can actually win a chip if you keep it together. So it's exciting.
Well, we can't wait to see you celebrating when the Lakers make the playoffs this year.
Yes.
We'll see you out there going crazy. Thanks so much, Ice Cube,
for
joining us this morning on Get Up. We got plenty more to come your way this morning. This man was the Rookie of the Year, six-time All-Star. He scored nearly 16,000 points in the NBA, but none since 2016. Can Amari Stoudemire make a comeback? We'll ask him face-to-face in 5 minutes right here on ESPN. We'll be right back.
Welcome to a